Hey, what's up folks, my name is Ashok Joshi and welcome to AJ Media YouTube channel. And in this video, we will try to install and configure CentOS 8 in Oracle's VirtualBox. So without wasting any time, let's start with the video. So at the very first, what I will do is I will click on this Google Chrome. So I will go there and what I will do here is I will go to google.com and I will type here CentOS download. And at the very first, you can see here, there's a project or link that we see, which is from www.centos.org. Click on this link, which says download CentOS. Just click here. And I will be using CentOS 8 in this video series. So you can also go for CentOS 7. So the installation procedure and the working of both are pretty much same. Okay, so you can use anything. So CentOS 7 is around 4 GB or something, and CentOS 8 it is around 10 GB. If you guys have any data limit, go for CentOS 7. So it will basically give you the total Red Hat experience, and the package managers and everything will be similar to that of Red Hat distribution, and it is free, no cost required. So that's why I am using CentOS 8. So now what you can do here is you can click on this architecture link that says x86-64. Click here and this will redirect us to this page. So where you can see there are multiple links. So just click here the first one. Now after clicking here, you can see there are multiple ISO images, the links. And what you can do here is you can click on this DVD1.ISO. Okay, so which is of around 10 GB. Click this, and after clicking this, this will start downloading the CentOS 8 ISO file. Now I have already downloaded this file, so that is the reason I will be cancelling it. So you will have to download this ISO file. Okay, so now what I will do is I will head over to google.com, and what I will do here is I will write Oracle VirtualBox download. Once you see this downloads Oracle VM VirtualBox, by the way, VirtualBox is a VM. VM means virtual machine. And let's click on this link and this will redirect us to this page. Now what you'll have to do here is you will have to click on the Windows host if you are on a Windows machine. So currently I'm using Windows 11. So I'm in Windows machine. So I will click on this link. So what it will do is it will start downloading the exe file of VirtualBox. It's around 103 MB. So what I will do is I will cancel it because I have already downloaded Oracle's VirtualBox as well. So you will have to download these two files. Okay. So once everything is downloaded, what we'll do is we'll go to the destination folder where we have these two files. So at the very first, what you will have to do is you will have to install Oracle VirtualBox. By the way, you can use Oracle VirtualBox or even you can use any hypervisor. For example, you can use a VMware workstation player as well. So now what I will do is I will just double click this Oracle VirtualBox.exe file. This will open this kind of wizard. So what you'll have to do is you'll have to click next here. So after this, click on next, and here it will ask for some options. I don't have any problem. Click next here. It will say some network interface warning. It will temporarily disconnect you from the internet. So it asks whether you want to proceed with the installation now or not. Click on yes, no problem. Click on install. This will ask whether you want to install. Click on yes now, and this will start installing. So once this is installed, we will be back. So now once everything is installed, you will see this kind of wizard with a checkbox that is ticked, and it will say start Oracle VM VirtualBox after installation. So what I will do is I'll just click on this finish. Simple. This will open up Oracle's VirtualBox. And okay, let me click here. So this is how it looks. Let's create a virtual machine of CentOS 8. Let me click on this new icon, and after this it will say create virtual machine. So what you'll have to do is you'll have to give the name. So what I will do is I will give CentOS VM. VM stands for virtual machine, which is just an emulator where you can, you know, get the experience of a particular operating system. You can create as many virtual machine as you can. So if you create multiple virtual machine, it will be stacked here one by one. If one is there, then the second one, you can create as many virtual machine as you can here, depending upon the kind of a computer that you are using. So let's not worry about that, and let's just start the installation of this CentOS virtual machine. So it will show you the machine folder where everything will be installed. So it's in my C drive, users Ashok Joshi, and inside this folder. Now, and this type will be Linux, and version it will take automatically Red Hat. If it is not picking, then you can just click on this and you can take it out. Okay, you can pick it up. So now let's click on next. So now here it is the main thing that you should correctly allocate. See here, if I am using 4GB here, that means my system is able to adapt such kind of RAM. So it depends upon how well your computer is. If your computer is pretty old, then my recommendation is go for 1024MB or 1GB. So if it is a good machine, for example, if it is having 16GB of RAM, 8GB of RAM, go for 4GB. It will give you a better experience. Now, what I will do is I will type 4096. Okay, now click on next here. Okay, so now let's allocate hard disk. So go with the default one, which is the create a virtual hard disk now. So the recommended hard disk space is 8GB. So this is the minimum hard disk size that you'll have to allocate. Now what is this hard disk? Imagine your computer. There is a hard disk, right? Where you can store some information. You have installed something in that hard disk, right? So the same way we are creating a virtual machine. So it is a kind of virtual computer that we are creating where you will have to allocate some hard disk space. That's it. Simple. Now let's create it. And here, what type of hard disk it should be? Just go with the default VDI, VirtualBox disk image. Click on next. And after this storage of physical hard disk, go with the default dynamically allocated. Click on next here. Now this is the storage part. How much storage that you want to allocate for this virtual machine or this virtual computer. Now here what you'll have to do is you'll have to allocate the location and size of the hard disk. The location it will pick automatically. So here it has picked something like C user and my name, virtual machine, and so it has created this location and it is taking up. I don't have any problem. So now what you'll have to do here is the recommended size is 8GB. So if your computer is very old and it is very slow, go with 8GB. And if your computer is very good, so what you can do here is go with 30GB. I am allocating 30GB here so that I get good experience using this virtual machine. Now I'll click on this create. After clicking on create, you will see here there is a virtual machine that is created. Okay, so that is how you create a virtual machine inside VirtualBox. So you can create as many virtual machines as you can. So it will be stacked one above the other. So if I create any other, it will be stacked below this thing, and so on it goes on. Okay, and now what you can do here is you can just start this virtual machine. Once you click on that start, you will see this kind of installation wizard, and here it will ask you to select the disk. So what is this? Basically, you'll have to give the ISO file. So click on this icon that says choose a virtual optical disk file. It is asking to choose the ISO image of this particular virtual machine. Okay, I'll click on this. So what you will do is you'll have to click on add. So what you'll have to do is you'll have to go to the folder where you have the ISO image that is downloaded. So once you go there, you can click on the ISO image. So in this case, it is CentOS 8. You can also use CentOS 7. I'll click on this open. And what you can do here is you can click on choose. That's it. So once you choose it, you will see the ISO name here, right? So after that, what you can do is you can click on this start button. Once you click on start, this will start the Oracle's virtual box. So now what you can do here is you can click the up arrow and down arrow key to navigate up and down. So what you can do here is go to install CentOS Linux 8, and after that you can click enter. Once you click enter, this will start reading the ISO image. Okay, it will start installing your operating system. Now what we'll have to do is we'll have to wait here. Okay, so now you can see here it is saying welcome to CentOS Linux 8. So what you can do here is you can click on English, and you can click on the region. If you are in United States, United Kingdom, based upon the region, you can click on this option. So I am in India, so I will click English India. So you can click United States or Kingdom, whatever, whichever the region you belong to, and click on continue. Now, once you click on continue, you can see here the default keyboard, it will be taken, and the local installation media, it will take automatically. Just click here and you can see here auto detected. Okay, it will automatically detect. So nothing you'll have to do here. So the next thing that you can see here is the partitioning, the installation destination. Click on this. So it will automatically show you the 30 GB hard disk file that we had created. You make sure that this is ticked, and after this what you'll have to do is click on this done button. Now once you click on done, it will automatically take that particular hard disk. Now what you'll have to do here is you'll have to see what is the software selection. Okay, so click on that. Here you can see there are so many add-on packages which you can later install using something which is called as Yum. So that we will be seeing in the later part of video. So we have other options as well, like server. We have an integrated, easy to manage server. You have something which is called as minimal install. So basically this is for just basic functionality. And we have other things which is workstation, custom operating system, virtualization host, and everything. So do one thing, just click on this server with GUI and click on done. That's it. Now what you'll have to see here is you'll have to click on this date and time. If you are in America or New York, then this is fine. But I am in India, so what I will do is I'll click here. So based upon the region, you'll have to click. So India comes here. Let me click here. So it will take the location 1625. You can verify by going. You can see here, right? It's 425. Yeah. So that's how you can verify here. And you can specify the format, 24 hours or let's say 12 hours. You can click here, AM or PM. Okay. And now what you can do is you can just click on done. So it has taken the default date and time of my particular zone. So it has taken the time and date that I wanted. And now I want to do here is click on this network and let's on this thing. Okay, so this is the Ethernet, so that it indicates that whenever I log in to this particular virtual machine, it will be connected to the Ethernet or network or the internet. Now here you can see what is my host name. It is localhost. What I will do here is I will write CentOS and I will click on apply. You can leave it default, but I will write CentOS here. Okay, so now what I will do is I will click on done. So as you can see here, it is now wired, so it is connected to the internet. And let's click on security policy. There's nothing, so just click on done here. And now what you'll have to do is click on this root password, and you'll have to set the password of root. So you'll have to give the password of root. Always try to give a strong password, but if you cannot remember the password, you can give weak password, as this is just a virtual machine that we are using in our system. But in the company, they will definitely recommend using a strong password. Okay. Now what you'll have to do is you'll have to create a user. So what I will do now here in my case is I'll give my name, and let me give the username as Shubh Joshi. I will not make this user as an administrator. There's a reason. I'll explain you in the later videos. And I'll give the password. Okay, now click on this done. So what we have done is we have created the root password, we have set it, and after that we have created the user as well. Click on this begin installation and this will start installing your CentOS virtual machine in VirtualBox. So this will download package, it will start installing CentOS in virtual machine, or you can say VirtualBox. And once this is done, I will be back. Once CentOS is completely installed, you will see here complete. And now here you can see CentOS Linux is now successfully installed and ready for your use. Okay, so what you'll have to do is go ahead and reboot your system to try using it. Just click here reboot system. Now what it will do is it will reboot the particular virtual machine that we have created, in this case the one which we have installed currently. Okay, so now this is starting, and what you'll have to do is click enter. And now what you can see here is it will start the installed CentOS. And by the way, if you want to get your cursor out of this virtual box, click on control that is in the right side of your keyboard. So once you click on control, you will be outside of the virtual machine, and if you want to get inside, just click here. Okay, and what it is saying, licensing information. Okay, so what you'll have to do is you'll have to just click on this checkbox and which says I accept the license agreement. Click on done and finish configuration. So that will finish all the steps. And now you can see here that the initial screen that has come here, you'll have to enter the password that you had already given over there. Remember that I showed you. After giving your password, this will let you inside. So that's how CentOS 8 looks like. Let me zoom this. Okay. Click on next here. And after this, what I will do is I'll click next because I don't have any problem. Next. Skip this step and start using CentOS Linux. Now this will show you some getting started help, and just click cancel. And that's how it looks like. And if you click on activities, you can see the applications at the left corner, and you can also click on this show applications, the 9 dots, so that you can see what are the applications installed which you will get at the time of installing. These are some utilities and so on. So once you have installed CentOS 8 inside Oracle VirtualBox, you can see something, you know, the screen looking so small. So in my case it is very small here. So what we can do is we can install guest editions. So in this video, we won't be installing the guest edition. So in the next video, we will try to install guest edition, and we'll try to make this particular, you know, the operating system in full screen mode so that we enjoy learning Linux. Okay, so this is very small. Even if I open up the terminal, you see it's very small and it's not looking good, right? So better what we'll do in the next video is we will try to install the guest edition and make this particular thing look bigger, okay, or the full screen mode. So thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Do hit that like button if you guys have enjoyed, and comment down what are your thoughts about this video, and do share it with your friends if you feel that this video can benefit your friend. And if you are new to my channel, please do hit that subscribe button, click on that bell icon so that you will never miss any update whenever I will post a new video in future. So thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I will see you in my next video. Bye bye. Take care.